लेट अस बिगिन भगवद गीता वर्स नंबर 19 ऑफ 9th चैप्टर. श्री भगवान उवाच तपाम यहमहम वर्षम निगृह्णाम युत्सृजामि च अमृतं चैव मृत्युश्च सदा सच्चाहम अर्जुन. सो भगवान कृष्ण हैज गिवन, देर आर थ्री काइंड्स ऑफ भक्ति. वन इज मंद भक्ति, मध्यम भक्ति एंड उच्च मीन्स उत्तम भक्ति. अमंग दिस थ्री लेवल्स ऑफ भक्ति नाउ भगवान कृष्ण कंसिडर्स एज वी आर बिकमिंग इंटरमीडियरी भक्तास. देयरफॉर ही इज एक्सप्लेनिंग फॉर मध्यम भक्तास द भक्ति विच इज इन बिटवीन. मीन्स मध्यम मीन्स in second level. So he thought everything, I am the cause and life source. I am also in the form of death. This is where we stopped yesterday. In these words, I become the life source in the form of sun. Because I nourish all the beings through my rays, and I also become cause of the rain. Because rain will produce food, food becomes a very good nourishment for human being. And the nectar means I am the moksha karanam, it's known as immortality. Then I am the cause of mortality too. I am the mrityuhu. Mrityu means kala. Lord Yama, that everybody should wait for Lord Yama. Whether we wish or not, he will take our life. He follows properly dharma, therefore he is known as Yama Dharma. The Patanjali gives the first principle is called Yamam, then Niyamam, Asanam, Pranayamam, it goes on. This Yama means perfectly following and practicing something. This Lord Yama, who is nothing but Ishvara, he follows it properly. Whatever the time is given, if the time is finishes, so he takes without seeing any aspects of the life. Maybe, you know, after producing a baby, the mom's life must be taken, he'll take. Or after a baby is born, immediately he should take the baby out, he will take. So death. There we will see so compassionate Bhagavan Ishvara become so uncompassionate one. So he is out of compassion. Okay. So that it seems to be like that. No, it is. It has to be done. Otherwise, you cannot give another Sharira. He will arrange for another Sharira to get into another world according to our karma phala. Therefore he says aham mrityuhu, means from the birth he is with us in the form of so many things. After every cell become decay, then the cell must be rejuvenated. So maranam is on from the birth to death. So maranam is taking in us in so many forms. But when we lose this whole entire system, we call it maranam. No, maranam is the part of our life. Okay, so every cell is rejuvenated, dead cell being removed, a new cell is being produced. This everything is because of what? Aham mrityuhu. The Lord Ishvara becomes the source of destruction. So it never fails. If he has the plan, he executes it well. Then, aham satcha asatcha. These two words are very complicated word. Usually, sat means trikale yat tirthati, it is sat. But here, that which remains forever without undergoing any modification is known as sat. But in this place, it's not that meaning. Here it refers karya prapancham, karana prapancham. What is it? Karya prapancham, karana prapancham. We have already seen there are two kinds of prakritis. One is higher nature of Ishvara called para prakriti, and another is known as lower nature of Ishvara, apara prakriti. Apara prakriti, which is there in eight varieties of form. So five element and mind, buddhi, ahankara, rupena. We saw in seventh chapter. See, this apara prakriti, otherwise, in simple way, mayaji. Mayaji is known as asati here. So now the meaning has changed, ulta. So asati means that which is perishable. But here asati means maya, avyaktam. It's known as karana prapancham. But Ishvara is beyond that. Now karana prapancham is subtle, that which never comes into manifestation, into name and form. Karana prapancham, it very much exists in the karya prapancham. So don't get confused. The tree is a karyam, the seed becomes karanam. But the seed also is karyam, there is an energy that becomes karanam. Karanam means cause. So cause and effect. Now effect is known as sat. Sat means the whole empirical world, that which is evident to deal with, to see, to understand. So as different materials. Now these all materials are known as sat, that is me. So anything that comes into the form, it has got its own glory. So many varieties of beings are available. So in Upanishad, it is said there are 33 crores of varieties of beings are available. You go under the sea, the deep sea, there are so many varieties of beings. So they are very colorful. If you go to the forest or if you go to the mountains, you know, like Himalayas. So if you go into, you know, near the Everest, Mount Everest, no human being, no other being, but there are some beings available. In Antarctica, there are some beings available. And those beings, they have their own lifestyle. There are many number. In fact, so when we live, nowadays we have started constructing the societies. In Mumbai, it's, you know, all the skyscrapers. In Malaysia, skyscrapers. So if you go to village or town, so where there is no skyscrapers, even in the skyscrapers, there are ants. They have their own world, all cockroaches and all worms and all bugs, you know, they have their own world. Everything is nothing but me. Everything is nothing but me means what? So I am the source of those karya prapancha. Karya prapancha means it has got its own program. We have learnt in different way. Now if you see, you see a snake, so nicely given the design, the skin of the snake. So we terrify by seeing that, because so that the matter of the life and death. But if the snake is kept in the zoo, if you are safe because it is in the cage, that cage also, it's a glass cage. So now you can enjoy by seeing. And people who are afraid of snake, they don't even look at all. But if you see the architecture of, I use the architecture because nicely designs the skin. A tiger skin, very nicely designed. The lion skin, elephant, an elephant has got a nice skin. So that color, so you can see it's a elephant color. Gray means it's an elephant color. Everything is marvelous. A rock, if you go to Narmada, you can get the linga. So no architect is needed, no engineer needed, no carpenter is needed, no sculptor is needed to create that linga. It, the beautiful Shivalingas are available in Narmada. Because it's manufactured by the water flow. So every stone becomes linga over there. No other river has this glory. this kind of so many glories, the physical world itself, you know, it has got godliness. He says, that is nothing but me and the Maya who is sitting inside of every object, being a cause, karana prapancha, being in a subtle form, it becomes cause of this effect, karya prapancha. So both of them is nothing but me, my dear Arjuna. Please try to understand. Now, if a devotee, so the devotee, when he learns this, he will respect every object, every creature in his life. That attitudinal change will automatically take place. But one thing we have to remember, a snake must be kept its own place. We should not disturb them, at the same time we should also protect us. It doesn't mean to destroy that species. We have to take care of them. We should give the space to them. Therefore, now the Indian government is making lots of efforts to save the forest animals, because rare elephants and tigers and lions are available in India. So that effort is on. So because of God's grace, we will be succeeding in that those efforts. Then the next words, Traividya mam soma paah puta paah yajnairishtva svargatim prarthayante te punyamasadya surendra lokam ashnanti divyan divideva bhogana. So up to the last words, so Bhagavan Krishna begin from verse number 12. So from verse number 12 onwards up to 19th verse, he explained about this nishkama bhaktas, means a selfless bhaktas who are superior upasakas than the sakama bhaktas. And also he said, so they accept Lord as a prapancha. Therefore, for them, whatever they experience, they see, it's nothing but God alone. But so inferior to those bhaktas, the bhaktas, they feel they want to achieve something. They are attracted with the worldly materials, enjoyments. You know, you see, so many songs are available now. Not only the movie songs, there are many albums are available and many music directors are there, and they have become world famous. India is producing so many talent souls. So those souls, you know, they have their own way of entertaining the people. So how can I give up that in the name of spiritual? Should I give up those things? Every day there is a serial. In the serial, all the problems of family is shown. So how can I miss it? I cannot miss them. So I want colorful life. I want colorful experience, different experience. Experience in my city, experience in other cities, experience in other countries. So even the experience other planets. Okay, that's what the human tendency. Those beginning level bhaktas and their ability and effort is for what is explained in the forthcoming verses. Okay, so here in this verse he says, Traividya mam soma paha puta papaha yajnairishtva surgatim prapayante. Soma paha. So soma paha means soma rasa is a drink. So which was in the ancient time, there is no the drink now. And many people, they mistake it's a alcoholic. No, it's not an alcoholic. The somarasa, it's a medicinal plants. But it gives some kind of the drowsiness. Or we can say some kind of what we call it alcoholic tendency. That it becomes, it brings the effect of little bit alcoholic effect. Not alcoholic effect means what I mean to say. So they become drowsy people. They are feeling, they may feel they have drunk something else. This soma rasa, it's healthiest, but they should use only as the prasada from that ritual called Soma Yaga. So one who has drunk Soma Rasa, they are known as Soma Paha. Soma Paha means Somam Pibanti Ti Soma Paha, the drunker of Soma Rasa, and with the help of Trividya. Trividya means here the knowledge of three Vedas, Rig, Yajur, Sama. Because of the knowledge, with the help of knowledge, they are performing so many rituals. So once upon a time in our Sanatana Dharma, so many rituals were performed by those people. Even in those time, materialistic people also used to perform, their life motto is to perform more rituals, because they are connected with these adrushtas. Now we have become grossified people. Now it's a different technology development. This is also people enjoy. But in those times, technology wise, they were not that much developed. But they have developed in subtle way. That development have been lost now. From the mind, you know, Arjuna could have the weapon with mantra shakti. When he chants the mantra, the weapon comes in his hand. So nowadays, we need to have tankers, containers, and flights to carry all the weapons. In those days, a very much popular weapon, powerful weapon, greater weapon in the universe, they could tie, they could have with they could have the control with the help of mantra. Therefore, we used to say that shastras, astra, shastras. Nowadays, we have lost that capacity. Now, everything has become gross. So, gross level, mind also have become gross level. Now, these youngsters, they have lost calculating capacity because they do have the calculator in the mobile. So even for normal equation, normal calculation, they are using the mobile. When you use like this, so we will lose the ability. In those days, yajnairishtva swargatim prarthayante, they wish all the enjoyment through rituals. Even they wish the enjoyment in this world and hereafter. Swargatim, swargadvaram, they fix the destination, even Swarga. So in those days, because they were very much aware enough. So whenever I say Swarga, means immediately people look it up. The Swarga is not upside. It's physically you cannot find anything. Even in our body, I will give an example, you know, concept how we have to understand, that would be very much clear to you. So if you are looking for the disease, you have the disease, okay? So the disease, you need to have equipments. So if your blood has got too much starch, means undigested starch, it's known as sugar, you are called a diabetic person. So that sugar, how we will find? You need to have the equipments. So if you take the blood, if you see that, it's not visible. And this all disease, every disease is not even visible with the tools, equipments. If you have the pain, so pain is not visible. They will analyze, you know, due to this and due to that, it may be caused. So they will vaguely, they will assume it's all guessing job. It won't help. In the same way, you should not have this guessing job with Swargadi Lokas. It's not constructed in the air. There is a loka. You think after death where we go? We are going or not? If you think we are not going anywhere, then what happens to a soul after death? Do you have an answer? No, I don't have an answer, but I cannot accept this theory of Swarga and Naraka. Don't accept. Who is compelling you? You need not accept. But if you accept, you can have proper life here. If you accept, you will get an understanding that understanding will bring attitudinal change with the action you perform. That actions which is performed with a different attitude will fructify different glories. I call it glories, all punya phalas. Therefore, ritual needs this kind of shraddha. Ignairishtva putapapaha. So, two adjectives. Somapaha, putapapaha. Putapapaha means so cleared all sin. The people who cleared their sin by following the rituals. They reach Swargadi Lokas by praying me. Because he has already told, I am the Kratu, I am the Yajna in the last few verses. But here Sakamas, they are attracted to this world. Okay, what happens to them? Because they achieve Punya. Punyam Asadhya, Surendra Logam Ashnanti. They enjoy even the Loka here, the world. Definitely they enjoy, you know. Nowhere it is become evident a person who is living with all the rituals, he is suffering. Nowhere you could see. I am very sure if anybody is suffering by doing the rituals, he is not guided well. So if a person is guided properly, if he does, if he performs the ritual, he will definitely will get what he wants. I have seen even people who are in politics, they are performing a lots of rituals so that they are able to come again and again. So it's a wonder, but it's kept very secret. That's what very secret means. So rituals benefit must be, you know, let people know. But we are not doing that. It has to be done. But it has to be governed by dharma. That's what one thing I am very sure about. Okay. Now he see, punya masadhya, achieving punya, they reach the lokas of Indras, Surga the lokas, Divyan Didi Deva Bhogan. They also enjoy celestial enjoyment. Celestial enjoyments means what? See, this world has got so many new enjoyment, but the celestial enjoyment, it becomes more, means a thousand times more than this earth, but you will also have the capacity. Now, if you listen music for 3 hours with the earphone, the ear becomes damaged. But in Swarga, you can keep on listening the music. You can keep on eating. You can keep on enjoying whatever the enjoyment you think. No limit there. That's what is known as Swarga Loka. No sadness. You just you divide these two. So on the earth we have both sadness and happiness. The happiness only remains in the Swarga. Sadness, it remains only in the Naraka. Therefore we are very carefully understand Swarga means where there is no sadness. Okay. Naraka means where only sadness, no happiness. Because that is evident. This logic is good. You can understand, yes, Swarga is possible. But what happens when they enjoy? Will it be long lasting? No. That's what is said in the next words. Let us read. Te tam bhaktva swarga lokam vishalam kshine punye martya lokam vishantim evam trayi dharma manuprapannaha gata gatam kama kama labhante. Te tam bhaktva swarga lokam vishalam kshine punye martya lokam vishantim. Very important sentence in the whole Bhagavad Gita regarding Sakama Bhaktihi. You just underline it. They, those people who are mentioned in the last words, Somapaha, Putapapaha. By having great effort, they could perform huge yagas, yajnas, and they would get good reputation in the society. They are sent to Swarga Loka. They enjoy for thousands of years or hundreds of years. then after what happens, if their punya account is completed, means it is gone zero, they will be sent back to the same Martya Loka. Martya Loka means the loka where death is available, pain is available, suffering is available. He will come with zero punya, then he has to begin. So once zero punya means no human birth. Again from, so the basic level he has to come up again. Evam tri dharmam anuprapannaha gata gatam kama kama labhante. Not knowing the fact of these karma phalas, people, they have desire to travel, to come back, not knowing they are into the circle of samsara. This verse is very important. Te tam bhukva swargalokam vishalam. Swargaloka is vishalam. There is no restriction of land. You can have, you know, how much land, how many wells you want. No government will ask for the tax. There is no GST, no any other tax. You can enjoy vishalam swargam. But if your account is finished, means what? Your money is finished, you will be kicked back. Money here is punya. You will be kicked back. So you are not even given the notice. Just you will be sent back to Martya Loka. This verse is main verse for sadhakas who wants to get further development in bhakti. So Bhagavan Krishna, he mentions in between. You know, this verse comes exactly in the middle of Bhagavad Gita. He just gives a solid dose. Anybody who goes, they have to come back. If they are continuing with the desired oriented life, so what shall we do? Then we have to hold Ishvara alone, comes in the next verse. Ananyas chintayanto mam ye janah paryupasate tesham nityabhiyuktanam yoga kshemam vahamyaham. It's a beautiful verse. So the verse for all bhaktas. Ananyas chintayanto mam ye janah paryupasate. Ye janah ananyas chintayantaha mam pariyupasati tesham yogakshemam aham vahami. Nitya abhiyuktanam tesham yogakshemam aham vahami. It talks about the complete surrendering and people who are surrendered completely. That we will continue from next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om.